Hello everyone, in this video we will find the solution for find all the duplicates in an array. So given an array of integers which vary from 1 to n, that means we have the elements of the array between 1 to n. It will not be like it will be negative or 0. So some elements appear twice and others appear once. So we have to find the duplicate elements which appear twice or which we have seen before also. So we have given an input array like this 4. 3, 2, 7, 8, 2, 3, 1. So the 2 is repeating and the 3 is repeating. So our output will be 2 and 3. So we can use a brute force solution also. So I will show you how to that. So we can use a brute force solution also. We are given 1, 3, 4, 2, and 1. We can like use, we can iterate using two loops. For first loop, we have I like is equal to 0. We will run from I 0 to n, which will be the length of array, and we will iterate another loop in a nested loop under this, which will be j is equal to, we'll run from 0 to n, and we will have an additional condition for this, because it should not be like the element is getting matched with itself. So we will check for the index, and I is not equal to j, which means the index of I is not equal to j, element is not matched with itself. But this solution will not be like good, so it will be of O n square complexity, which is not at all tolerable, because we can do it in like we can do it in O n complexity, and it will be a constant space. So we will find for the, we will search the better solution. So we have hashing. Most of the languages offer hashing also. So in hashing, like we have a dictionary. So I will show you basic syntax. I'm like showing you the Python syntax mostly. So we have an input array like this 1, 3, 4, 2, and 1. So our output should be 1 because 1 is repeating. So we have a pseudocode like this. We have a dictionary, like in Python, we have a dictionary. So dictionary is like we will iterate, we have created a dictionary D. So we will iterate through all the elements of the array. That will be let me increase the size. All the elements of the array. So first we iterate to 1. This 1. So as we iterate to 1, 1 is not present in the dictionary. So we will add 1 and increase its frequency to 1. So that we have visited it. Now we will iterate to 3. 3 has not been visited, not in the dictionary. So we will again initialize the 3 to 1, frequency of 3 to 1. We have seen it one time. So we will iterate to next element, that is 4. We have not seen 4 also. We will initialize the 4 as 1, frequency with 1. So when we iterate to 2, next element, so then we have not seen 2 also in the dictionary. So we will again set it to 1, initialize it to 1. Now when we iterate to 1, so here you can see the condition for element in array. If the element is not in D, then we initialize it. But if element is in D, so we will increase the frequency of that. So 1 plus 1 will be 2. So the frequency of 1 will be 2. And now we can check for the element for element in dictionary whose like frequency is for D. Element whose frequency is greater than 1, that will be the repeating element. So we will print that element. So that's the solution using hashing, and we can use set also. Similarly, set will contain only the unique elements, not the duplicate elements. So when the duplicate element like comes in the loop, then we will print that element. So this solution is efficient in time complexity, but it will take O n space also for the dictionary that we are using to save the output, save the frequencies of the element, then we will iterate it again. So this is O n complexity. We will like iterate to the loop, and again we will iterate through the loop for finding the element with a greater than 2 or 1 frequency. So it will also be in O n. So O n plus O n is equal to O n. And for the dictionary, we are using ON, the space complexity. So we have a better solution than this, which will be, so this is the solution with ON time and ON space complexity. it will be better than hashing because it is using only the constant space. So we are given an input array 1, 3, 4, 2 and 1. And so the repeating element is 1, that is duplicate element. And here I have written the pseudocode. So basically the idea for this algorithm is if we are visiting the element 1, then we will make it as index. We will use it as index to go to the other element and mark it as negative. So if the element is positive, then we will mark it as negative. Otherwise, if the element is negative before we are visiting it, so that it will be the repeating element basically. So that will be our output. So I will show you the code. So I will run from 0 to 4 basically. So we will iterate from the first element. I will be at 1. So it is based on 0 indexing. So we will have to mark -1 from them. So if it is 1, then we will use it at -1. So it will become 0 according to, so because the array indexes are 0 or 0 indexed. So I will be at first at 1, and 1 minus 1 is 0. So element we will use it first for filling an array is this 1 minus 1, and it will become array of 0, and array of 0 is basically 1. So we will go to this index that is 0 and mark it as negative. Okay, and then we will iterate the I to next 3, and we will subtract 1 from 3, that is 3 minus 1, that will become 2. And we will go to the second index, that is 0, 1 and 2. And we will mark it as negative if it is not negative. If it is positive and greater than or equal to 0. So we will mark 4 as negative. And now we will iterate to the next element, that is 4. And we will take the absolute value of 4 because we are not using the negative indexes. So we will take absolute value of 4, that will be 4. And we will subtract 1 from it to map it to the index of the array, that will become 3. And then we will check the third index, 0, 1, 2 and 3, and it is 2. So second element is positive, and so we have not visited it before, or it is not duplicate, so we will mark it as negative again. And now we will iterate to the next element in the array. I will go to 2, and we will use 2 as the index for the next element, so it will become absolute value of 2 minus 1, that would be 1. And we have not visited 1 because it is positive, that is 3, so we will make it as negative. Now I will iterate to the next element, that is 1. Now we will check for the index 1 minus 1 is equal to 0, and we will go to the 0 index, and 0 index is negative. So that means it is a repeating element. So 1 is a repeating element, so we will print it. Else for this is a pseudocode. So here you can see we are using array. So we are basically using the element of the array. Then we are taking the absolute value of it because we are marking them as negative. So we need to make them positive, and we will do minus 1 to make it as 0th indexed array element. So it will this output will be like between 0 to n. So if it is 1, then it will become minus 1 and 1 minus 1 0. So array of 0 is basically our 1. So we will mark it as negative. So this is what we are trying to do. And so I will show you the code also of this solution, and I will give the code in the description also in C++ and Python, both languages. You can download the code from there also. And now we will show the I will show you the solution on the lead code. This is the code for our problem. So we are given an array numbers in which we have to find the duplicate elements. So we have to output return the list of the repeating elements. We will use the result array or list in Python. So we will iterate to the elements in the array length. So if the we have seen and tried and the pseudocode, so it will be similar to this code. So if we will iterate to the number, and in the numbers element we will check if it is we will check for the absolute value of it and subtract 1 from it to make it zero indexed array, and then we will check if it is greater than 0, then we will make it negative because it has not been visited. So basically it is just one element that we are using, so it is getting a bit complex. I will explain you further I will explain you on this input. So else if it is negative, then it will be the repeating element, so we will add it to the result. So we will return the result array, and so I will show you first of all submit the code and check if it's working or not. And here you can see it got accepted. So it is in Python, so it is taking a bit more time than normal in C++. So this is our array. We will make it. This is our array, and we will iterate to it, and I will be first pointing to 4, and 4 we have 4 minus 1, that would be 3. So we will check on the third index. So we will write also index also here 0. One. Just a second. I'm not that great in formatting. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have the indexes here. So we will check for the third index, and this 7 is the third. 7 is on third index. So we'll make it negative, and the I will iterate to the next element 3, and then we will check 3 minus the 3 is positive. So we will get absolute value of it. 3 minus 1 is equal to 2. So we will check on the second element, and we will make it negative. And now we will iterate to the next element, that is 2, and we will take absolute value of minus 2, so which is 2 minus 1, then we will get 1. We will check for the 1, and first index element is also positive, so we will make it negative. And then we will iterate to the next element, that is 7, and we will take absolute value of minus 7, that is 7 minus 6. So 7 minus 1 will be 6. So we will search for the 6th index element, that is 3. So we'll make it negative, and then we will iterate to the next element, that is 8. Then 8 minus 1, similarly we find for all elements, is 7. So 7th index is this, we will make it negative, and then we will go to 2, and 2 minus 1 is 1. We will get 1, and we will check for the first index element, which is already negative. So means 3 is repeating. So we will print the 3, and you can see here this is minus. This is also 3, and this is also 3. So the output will be 3 first of all. Then we will iterate to the next element, that is 3, and so similarly we have similarly. 3, we will take absolute value of 3, that is 3, and minus 1 is equal to 2, and we will check for the second element, that is 0, one element at second index, that is 0, 1, and 2. This is 2, so it is negative before only, so it will be also printed in our output. So in this fashion, we will find out, and it will iterate next, but there won't be any element. So this is how we use a solution which takes O(n) time and O(n) space complexity. And it is based on like using the element as index, marking the another element as negative. So we can check if the element is negative before only, then it will be visited only. So it will be repeating element, then that would be our output. Thanks for watching, guys. Do subscribe to this channel and comment down for more programming questions that you want to see the solution of. Thank you, guys.